Warning. Elements of real-world religion are used in this podcast to serve the purposes of a work of fiction. They are to drive the drama forward and are not intended to be taken as a statement of opinion by the players. Thank you for listening.
Yes. I'm down.
Yeah.
I still love this song.
I will move a little closer, but I'll stay within
Michael.
A spirit range. Like so. An 18 to hit.
Oh, I'll hit him.
4 piercing damage.
You bite into him with your weapon, but he's still up.
Yep.
And he's, at this point, fighting on fumes. Like,
yeah, dance around him, quick cut to the waist.
An ordinary man would be down for the count at this point. He's bleeding out from multiple places, and he seems to still be a combatant.
Yep, Levi's just nodding at him.
He's like a, maybe not equal to you, but like, this is a legitimate threat.
Oh, totally.
You could lose this fight to him.
Yep. I'm enjoying the 6 rounds of compelled duel that I have left.
Yeah. I like the idea that you're still in your suit, and you're like, with the saber out, and you're doing the practiced fencing routine.
Yep.
But you're clearly wearing the Confederate suit, and he's like, trying to fight you off.
Mm-hmm. Oh, it's quite a visual.
Everyone has to see it.
Except all right. Jed.
Except Jed.
Temperance
sees it.
Knife goes down.
Knife goes in, guts come out.
Unzip, guts, zip.
Pretty much. Colonel
Open
Mustard
cavity, extract
can
guts.
Come get some.
Dang.
No, Kaylee, no, why?
I have no inspirations or nothing to give you.
Oh, cartoon wah.
Jed?
Death saving throw.
You make
success.
It.
Successful saving
if
throw.
If you're the one, you were dead forever.
You're one. I am not. I rolled a 16.
All right. The villain is still fighting you.
Yep.
He has no spells. All he's got is a
except
melee weapon.
Except for spiritual weapon.
Spiritual weapon moves over.
Yep.
Yep. Now he has an edge.
So here's the spiritual weapon. 19.
Hits exactly.
19, damn kid.
Wow. Yep. Defense paladin.
Nine points of bludgeoning damage.
Alright, hold on, concentration. Compelled duel is lost.
Okay. He doesn't care. He strikes you with his weapon, 20.
I think you have compelled him enough
hits.
To fight you.
Oh. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
3 more.
Alright, I'm still up.
He continues to strike
you. Yeah, the spiritual weapon we're behind, I wasn't expecting.
Yeah, it gets you really bad. Totally throws you off your, like, dueling
so
rhythm, like you're ready to fight this guy real.
Yeah. So that's 8 and then 3 from him?
Yep.
Alright, so full.
This dude gets up.
He has to make a saving throw at the end of his turn against Natasha's uncontrollable hideous laughter.
He does not. He falls down.
Good
that
spell.
Guy over there is being fought by a hooker
like
with a knife
stuff.
And a child. He's gonna go after the hooker. She seems more dangerous.
He's being fought by a hooker with a knife and a child. If you didn't hear what Ben just said.
He draws his own knife, duels a hooker with a 12. That wagon runs through the back of the corral and breaks the wall, and the two horses run off carrying
dice.
The wagon.
Well, that's entertaining, but it didn't do what I wanted it to do. We're supposed to run over.
This wagon runs into the fence. The horse closest to me clocks into it, gets injured by the hit, and it starts to like slowly list this way up the
flipped
wall.
Flipped over upside down. Look at it.
Yeah, it's having a bad time. The supplies crate opens up and bottles fall out.
Of nitroglycerin.
Of what?
Liquor.
Oh. Throw a match.
Sacramental wine.
We're gonna bless them all until we all get for sticker.
There's a tiefling. She comes in and drinks all of it.
Yes.
It is
Gideon's turn. Gideon, what do you got?
Really? Seriously?
My boy?
Bugs! I'm going to give her the help. So her next attack will be an advantage. So
good call.
Help
action.
All right.
Good call.
Stay right where I am to also give her the backstabbies.
I am going to try to come over here and stabilize Jedediah.
Ooh,
medicine DC
that.
10. DC is actually really low on medicine checks.
16.
You stabilize Jedediah. There's like pressure
I
on
go
it.
Over and I put a I pull off my neckerchief and I shove it into the wound that looks like it's bleeding the worst. And I just apply pressure and I'm actually like laying on top of you, using you as a rest for my run. So I'm actually gonna go prone.
That's hardcore as fuck.
And I'm gonna lay. I'm gonna stuff the neckerchief into his wound with one hand, and use my forearm as a rest for the rifle with the other hand.
Nice. That's fucking hardcore.
And you are stabilized.
Levi, you're still fighting the boss, man.
When the levy breaks.
You said he's not looking good, huh?
He's looking real bad.
Yeah.
How fucking stuck.
This spiritual weapon has fucked me off something fierce.
Yeah. He's put it in you.
Yeah, he has. Did 11 damage.
I want... we're out. I want rolls on the massive damage table from the DMG for Jeff.
You got some.
Because if he goes to cripple, I'm gonna retire. You can use him as NPC.
But what if he does?
Then he keeps going.
What if he loses like an eye?
Then he's a fucking badass. Then keeps going with one eye.
What do we got?
I will go full defense, and just say, actually, I will lay on a hand to myself for 5.
Yep.
No, never mind. Full defense.
You got it.
And just
dodge action.
And just tell everybody. I think it's time we finish this up, everybody. We've been playing long enough.
Jed responds with bleeding.
He bleeds. It's a minor action.
Back up against the supplies.
As a move action, his blood moves out of his body.
It's starting to wait.
All right.
That's it. Full defense.
Good choice, actually. Temperance.
Yeah,
what do you got?
Good choice.
Advantage.
I got stabby.
Stabby.
Stab his wiener hole.
It's a 13.
Hits.
Woo!
Barely. By 0.
Take your back stabby points, too.
Curse stabby.
Zoom tight.
Make sure you had your d6s for your back stabs, too.
We're both in the same boat, huh?
Oh, that's right. We're
on
get one
we're
of us.
Pity beer now. All
I keep
of a sudden,
thinking,
yeah.
Like, last time I played a rogue, I had like 5.
No.
Ooh.
7.
Killian
10.
Is a hero.
10.
10 points, really?
Yeah.
Oh my god. Yeah, you cut this man down. Gideon, you did a lot of work to help her out in this case.
Cut him down.
What is it the two of you do as a combo to kill this man?
I have a dagger too. I don't really use it, but I have one. I stab him in the foot, and when he yelps out in pain from that, she takes advantage of it.
He sort of goes down to like grab his foot, and she catches him like right in the throat.
That's gross.
It's a bonding moment.
Yeah.
He like sprays blood all over Gideon's face.
Yeah. Yeah, my mouth is open.
It's in my mouth, guys. It's in my mouth.
Jedediah.
What?
Bleeding
it's
out.
Called the
oh,
blood.
Yes.
I'm no, stabilized.
He's stable, actually.
Okay.
So he's down, right?
No saving throws. You have no hit points. You are okay.
Villain.
Sadly, you're just bored for the rest
of
the
turn.
It's villains.
Villains.
That was Levi.
Still a monster.
I did my job.
Ben, the soul monster. He's laughing hysterically.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Just on full defense.
You laugh yourself to death! No, he's still laughing. Alright, Jedediah is sort of out of the fight. I'm gonna pull his pin.
See how long that lasts.
Come on.
You're pulling my pin?
Yeah.
He detonates.
The villain. Still dueling Levi.
Now at disadvantage.
Still out of tricks.
All his attacks.
Yeah. So here's a spiritual weapon. Is he moving the spiritual weapon up?
Yeah. Yeah.
So the weapon sucks.
Thank you. Fuck.
And the cat of 9 doesn't suck.
What's it get?
21.
Yep, that's fine. I can take it from hitting that.
7.
Alright, I'm at 1.
Oh! Oh! So, as Killian said, you're dipped into your first level hit points at this point. You are seriously fucked up.
Yeah, it's a star across my face. Yeah.
It's such a shit.
Yep, I failed to block this one, and I'm too busy fending off the spiritual weapon, and then rake across the face.
As I said earlier, like, this guy's an equal combatant to you, and at this point, the tides have turned. Like, he has got the momentum.
Yep.
Except that now it's Gideon's turn.
So... I kind of more see him being hurt than you being under under attack.
Yeah, you see Doc like leaning up on his body, like putting pressure on wounds.
So I'm gonna run over here and I'm
Unless you got a healing spell, don't worry about it.
I have my little thing from the book that you
gave him the healing potion from the book, yeah.
So I open the book and I start thumbing through. I'm like, wait, it's right here. Hold on. And then
wait, I got something.
Whoa.
So one of Levi's eyes cut. That will come into play later.
Okay, the eye is out.
Not out, but
back.
Just cut.
So Gideon, I am like holding my handkerchief into one of his bleeding wounds, but I'm kind of using him as a rest to aim at this guy, and you come running over, and I'm just like, do what you gotta do, kid.
Yeah.
Help him out.
Yep. And so I do. I don't know if you told me have this under one action or a couple actions, but you said it was the equivalent of a.
It's a proper healing potion, so you use your action to feed it to him.
And what was the? Does anybody remember what that was?
2d4+4, I think.
Regular healing potion.
Yep.
2d4+4. 2d4+2.
There you go.
That's a good roll. 9.
Wow, that's huge. 9 hit points for Jedediah.
Woo! Yeah, boy.
Welcome back to the Lord of the Living. It's fucking nuts.
I'll pick up a shovel and keep digging.
Yeah.
You can't die yet, Mr. Blackburn.
Still more killing to be done.
Still more, well, I suppose. It's not what I meant. But I guess that's what you do.
That's pretty good. Doc, I see you rolling that die.
Do I have any sort of advantage against him because he's fighting Gideon?
Nope.
And his back's to me? No.
You mean Levi? Yes.
I'm going to do a non-sharpshooter shot at him.
A regular bullseye?
That is a 12?
Nope.
I miss.
Man, you are rolling cold tonight, huh?
I am. Comes around, yeah.
I told you, sharpshooter give it, then I take it away.
The first two sessions, your dice were on
fire.
The
universe is in balance, man. It's all good.
Yeah. Alright, Levi, you're in a duel, man. This is your stage.
I know. Let's see, the only Doc's looking at me right now, yeah?
Yeah, Doc, he's got a clear bead on you. Jedediah's not out for the count, but he's basically still out at this point.
Okay.
Gideon's focused on Jedediah, and Temperance is so
wild. That guy, make a con save.
A con save.
Yeah, I'll describe what happens.
Plus zero.
If he fails.
18.
That passes, nothing happens to him.
Sorry, dude.
It's fine.
Alright. Anything else?
You see Levi getting up in his face for a moment. It looks like he's abandoned reason for a moment, and then he just gets pushed off and gets back in a defensive stance.
Alright. Temperance.
There is one dude left in my zone.
Yes. In the murder zone.
Boop. The bone zone.
The bone zone.
Bone him.
13?
Negative. The bullet seems like it's on the right course. It goes right to his midsection.
And Jedediah's
off.
Jedediah's back up.
I am.
Jedediah's a combatant.
Standing. Mad. 1, 2, 3.
Roar.
Shoot! Mike! 12?
Nope.
Shit!
Wow, what bags of
rolls. I'm going down, guys.
Bags of shit rolls.
Anything else?
Nope. I used my action surge already. I got a buff.
It was a valiant effort, guys.
It was a really good effort. This man.
You have
bears his
teeth.
Skull,
though, right?
I do. That's going to be my only saving grace.
You just have a shitload of attacks against
you. Just putting the weapon next to me because I know you're going to use it.
Yep. He bares his teeth.
Yeah.
The spiritual weapon comes after you.
Mm-hmm.
That's 14.
Miss.
And the actual weapon comes down on you. Mm-hmm. 21. Okay.
Down.
Oh, fuck.
7 points.
Down.
And he turns back at the rest of the group. He's one of these.
Saving throw for Laughing Man.
He is 12.
Paul?
What?
Does 12 beat your saving throw?
No.
But he is still laughing.
For five more turns.
It's a whole minute, yeah.
Yeah, he's
I haven't had a reason to lose concentration, so, yeah.
Giddy up.
Giddy up. So now I'm kind of looking at this fucking tool.
Josh, you kept this boss busy for like seven turns.
Yeah. Mm.
That's pretty baller.
That's the point of paladins.
Yeah.
If I didn't have to drive home, I'd cheers you again.
Yeah, we can. Yeah, shit. Yeah.
So somebody actually hit this guy. Yeah.
We're trying.
The boneyard.
What did you hit him on?
I don't know. I got like 18 or higher every time I hit him.
I'll throw out there, the AC is 15.
You didn't have a solid stack, come on.
That's easier for the math purposes.
It takes away the mystique.
Fuck, everything I have is a wisdom save.
His mystique is 4 hit points long, dude.
Fuck it, let's try to Tasha's him. It's a wisdom save, so I bet you he'll miss.
Well, if you do it on him, it'll end on him.
Yeah, it's concentration.
Oh, you're right. So fuck that noise. Who is after me?
After you is Doc.
Where are you? Where are you? Physically?
I am right here.
Oh, don't you still have 10 left?
Fuck it. I'm going to go like right here, and I'm going to give you my hilt so you can shoot this guy at advantage.
There you go. Cool.
Aim better.
Yeah, really.
He, all right, he's gonna lean down to your left. Now the gents got up and walked away.
Hold your arm steady, sir.
Doc, you up?
Put your rifle in my hand.
If I have advantage, I'm gonna sharpshooter him.
You do, please. Cling tenaciously to my buttocks.
He's unhittable.
The fuck?
Yeah, it's an 11.
Oh my god.
He has to go on his side.
He does.
Motherfucker.
I'm strike one, guys. Strike one, death saving throw.
Holy shit.
Temperance.
This, wow! If this guy wipes us, I'll be very impressed.
Me
and
too.
Sad. I will actually kill. I will actually throw myself off.
I thought you were gonna say I'll actually kill myself.
Yeah. I'm gonna go drive off a bridge and get home.
I'll legit play in traffic.
God.
Jesus, this got dark quick. Yeah. I guess that's what happens when the whiskey runs out.
Yeah, we're all sad now.
This one.
No, this is just silence. No,
I'm not a fan of this song.
Great song,
man.
Some of the dogs are like, oh, good tune.
Yes, this one.
Temperance, what are you going to do?
She's going to hit. That's what she's going to do.
I'm going to
shoot him.
Well, it counts.
It counts.
It's a 24.
I request the highest of fives.
That was great.
She rolled
in the whiskey glass.
That was awesome.
I'm gonna get mine ready for next
turn. I love everything about life. All of a sudden, I don't want to play in traffic.
And max damage. Takes 9 points. Shit. I don't think I
care
this far.
If you want to phone a friend, you can.
So Levi's down. He's in the act of dying. Everyone else is shooting at this dude, and Temperance just sort of steadies her feet and lines up the shot real slow, like gets it in the center of his chest.
And what happens to him?
Blows him backwards because there's a joke there.
He tumbles up into the wagon, gets rolled up underneath the wheels, and the horses finally break the fence, and the wagon goes over his neck.
Oh,
wow, that's pleasant.
Levi is bleeding out, right?
Yeah. Who gets the first look?
Temperance, so Jedediah is
Jed.
Oh, somebody should finish this guy off. Chuckles over there.
Yeah, he's still around.
I'm a prisoner. I'm not going to say that out loud.
Do you want to do any movement or bonus actions or anything?
I guess you could
move over to that guy and get ready to kill him next to him.
Okay, before I decide what it is exactly Jed is doing, have we recognized anybody as being one of the people who assaulted Redstone?
Not specifically.
No, okay.
So Temperance is going to just turn around and walk back in to finish this guy off.
Fair enough. Yeah,
history check for funsies, but this
is
very
high. Bonus
everybody
action
or just
to,
me?
Yeah, I'll use my cunning action to dash.
Yep.
intelligence, right?
Yeah.
And I'll just slit his goddamn throat.
Three.
That should be next turn, I think.
No, it's movement, action. Movement.
Action was shooting that guy.
Oh, right.
Movement and cutting action to get over there.
Thank you.
So you're looking, Jedediah.
Yes, I am not trained in medicine, but I'm going to attempt to stabilize.
Well, yeah, there's.
If you let me go over there, I can give you a help with that, with my thing he gave me.
Can I delay my medicine check until Gideon comes over to me?
What I'm going to do is I'm going to take you out of initiative.
Okay.
I can describe what you see when Ben's done.
You are able to reach Levi. The combatant is easily dispatched by Temperance. And you were able to freely loot the establishment by which you have raided.
Can I interrupt for a second?
Assuming we save Levi, we save Levi's life.
Yes.
Jedediah, I have to describe what you see because of the wound.
That's how you do it.
Because of the wound that I took.
Well, so, first of all, I think it's worth noting that Jed, who has been a mercenary type of man since you've known him, foregoes looting pockets or corpses to help somebody who he pulled a gun on not one day ago and stabilize your wounds.
You see something in Levi's eye that got wounded. It's not so much that his face is slashed up a bit, sure, but in the wounding, something got ripped out of his eye. A contact. It is just an orb of blackness. When you open his eye to see if he's okay.
And I continue to perform medicine checks on him all the same.
Who's the first to loot material goods?
Not me. I mean, I'm going to make sure everybody's okay. That's going to be my first order of business.
Who is that guy or gal?
I'm taking care of him.
I'll try to take care of him.
Assuming it'll be one of you two that'll be the looty.
I'm trying to help him.
Looty, looty, point and shooty.
You are the looter?
Here's a box. Oh, okay. Hold on. Big time.
Nice chest.
Thanks.
That is stuff.
Loot.
Move your hands, Ben. Alright, you're good.
Amazing.
What is about to happen is happening in character. So, Temperance, please. You find this footlocker at the end of the bed in the tabernacle.
I'm looking.
Is it locked or it just has no lock?
Keeping my eyes
it's
shut.
Open.
Thwink.
You're in that picture. I'm sorry. I couldn't help it.
Sorry. Oh, damn.
Man, my larger sense just went through the roof. I was like, don't open it, let me check for traps. Go for it, Temperance, what do you got?
I'm just gonna take stuff out by the handful at this point. Letter book.
There's not a lot in the pages, I will tell you in advance.
I'm gonna flip through this and give it to Gideon.
RP-wise, it's the first two pages you care about.
I am not going to give this to anyone. Because I don't trust open liquor bottles.
Please read it aloud for the class.
April 29th, 1880.
It's May right now, by the way. Shit,
I pray this letter finds you well and in good health. I know that the Almighty shines his blessed light upon you. For I have heard good tidings of your efforts in... I can't read.
Duchesne,
thank you. Duchesne County. The swelling of the church swells to my heart in a way that reminds me of you. Gross. You may well recall in our many nights together... Gross. I have spoken plainly of the moments of solitude when... bare of back with bloodied cords that I felt closest to the divine. It was through this connection we forged our own bond, and it was in one of these moments that I was once again visited by the angel, Archangel Zariah. When Zariah spoke to me, it was with urgent direction. As was Moses tested by the Almighty in Egypt, so too will our faith so too will our own faith be challenged by the tasks set upon us. We must bring the four together. Brother Ephraim, in his studies, believes that the secret of the sword lies with a former Confederate captain whose photograph I have enclosed with this letter. He is a dangerous sort and may not take kindly to solicitors. You may wish to open communications with your allies in Texas. Worldly currency may be necessary to bring the captain to heel. I have also been told that the young master has been observed in Hope's Landing. Would that you spare a faithful soul to return that boy to us. He is young and scared and lacks the spiritual fortitude to face the realities of the world. My sojourn to Glidestaff nears its end, and I hope to see you again when my train arrives in Promontory next month. Would you believe the good son Demetrius insists on attending me? He is a godly lad. I have agreed to take him with me along with the anointed knights on my journey. Fare thee well, my dear Francis. I long only to look upon your face and feel your touch once more. In divinity, one, Shepherd Harlow Isaac Longway.
Yeah. Isaac. You know that name.
It's very nice, man. Well done.
Isaac, motherfucker, Isaac! Mm. Say you, he did.
Just let me know when Levi's awake.
Oh.
Isaac was the prospector in the bar, wasn't he?
No, Isaac was the stable master.
What else we got in here?
Oh, he was the stable master.
So let's start from the top. So that's
a shirt.
Well, we're making sure there's nothing in the
shirt. This is also a shirt. If you'd like to open it up, please do.
Jed needs new shirts. Ben, he's been shot.
I'm a LARPer.
I got you, dude. I got you.
I looked through everything.
All right. Kay already got the letter. We got the bottle of brandy from the top.
She just handed me this.
This looks like something important.
That looks like a Levi thing.
Yeah, it very much does.
This looks... No, fuck you. It's going in the lid.
Yeah.
I think you're going to see what that is. Why don't you tell the class?
A big bundle of dynamite, 5 sticks of TNT.
Light it, see what happens.
Is this a item?
Yep.
Like, do you guys mind if I
have at it.
Hang on to this?
Have at it.
We got little green bag here with a whole lot of dinero in it.
Mad loot.
Is this your photograph?
That'll
of
be the
your
photo. Yep.
Captain Boone Tag Guthrie, 3rd Cavalry, 2nd Confederate Hero, Missouri.
Missouri.
Could. What does that say?
This says, "Could he be the sword?"
Could he be the sword? Follow up cited last in Wayne County.
County.
Can I Francis. Roll history on that picture?
With advantage, please.
Please.
And then we've got Damon Olio,
format
of a dialogue.
Nine.
Something in this really old killer. Language.
Is that?
He was a man killer.
Ooh.
I wasn't finished that, but I'm wondering, is that something I know about?
It might be. Give me a history check with advantage.
It's a railroad schedule.
It's kind of shitty. 13.
It speaks to you on a fundamental level.
What is the date today?
It is currently May 4th.
So, commencing May 17th, 1869, I'm assuming that's 1880?
Mm-hmm.
Yep. From that date forward. Trans will run daily, blah, 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 blah. Arrive at Promontory at 11:05 p.m.
Why don't I take some liberties with her?
Go for it. I put it under the thing.
It's just padding.
I get you, man. I'm with you.
I hear you.
I made a lot of props. I understand.
Speaking of props, how much money is this?
Once you've found somebody you can fence it to, $550.
What?
Well, okay, so separating gems from coin.
That's half your tab.
Is that... Are you doing that or are you just calling it all gold?
I would call it all money when you find a place to fence it. This is literal gold coins
and also gems. This is, like, you need to find a person to sell this to.
As I am keeping track of the group of loot, until we fence this, it's considered group of loot.
The group of loot?
The group of loot. Yep. What is it, 500?
550.
And 50...
Dollaronis.
$150.
This seems like a thing you should have.
I'm taking some pretty big factory jumps with this.
Unless somebody takes it. Without, I mean, Levi's still unconscious.
You're awake by the time we loot the chest.
She starts opening the chest. I assume that I would be the second to come over and start looking through it because you were taking care of him, and you were doing whatever you were doing.
What does Levi see when he wakes?
But if I...
Probably my shocked face.
When I see wherever that necklace went, this...
What's wrong, Gideon?
It's kind of funny.
Well,
I think you might want to.
We all have our certain.
You might want to cover that up a little bit.
Lay on hands myself for 5.
When you wake up, I'm just gonna do this kind of in front of your face. Look familiar?
What have we here? Lacking the wings, but.
Was in this man's box of accoutrement.
Very curious. I take it.
The more I drink, the more I pick up your guys' stupid accents.
I take it that we won then. As he's talking, Levi is looking surprisingly cool and calm despite everything that happened. But right in front of you, he does trace his wounds where he was hit. And these little bits of energy just sneak out of his fingers. All right, that should be... And his wounds just knit themselves back together. This should do it. Now then, you said you... This eye, Gideon?
Yeah.
All right, well, just pay no mind to that. And I'll open the disguise kit and find a new contact. And within moments, Levi's eyes appear similar again.
Not weird.
Not weird at all. And he just smiles at you.
I'm gonna write down that I have a dynamite.
So I think only you two know about it right now.
5-6.
As I said before, Gideon, neither of us is quite right.
I don't engage.
A little weird out.
Be looking at the cross. Is any significance to me? It's very similar to the one that I have.
A religion check with advantage would be appropriate.
19.
Undeniably the cross of the people who were friends of your family.
Before or after? The vision.
Before.
Levi just kind of chuckles to himself. What a grand day we have had, everyone.
If you want to call it the head.
Oh, well, I'm feeling much better.
Are you okay?
He's got lines.
Are you okay? Are you two okay?
You see that the cuts across his face are now healed. There's just a scar where they were.
Both of your faces were in the dirt, so...
And, again, Levi seems just so calm after everything. I'm feeling very well, Doc. Thank you.
Good.
How are the rest of you?
Boone Guthrie.
That's a fine name, Jedediah. What does it mean to us?
Bushwhacker out of Missouri. My family spent plenty of blood fighting that man.
What is a bushwhacker?
Bushwhacker's a militia man out of Missouri, not a uniform fighter. Fought during the war, bandits and the like. It was a Jayhawk. Kansas man. Similar, not the same.
He gives you a look as like, does it say and?
Well, border fighting, banditry and the like. I lost my taste for it after the war. The heroism of it was gone. Good men, they lost what was good in them. They just fought to fight. That's when I left. But Boone Guthrie, he's something else. Murderer. Raped, killed my mama. Burning Lawrence, Kansas.
Ooh.
I cannot abide. I'll kill that man for free if we find him. Or I'll die trying.
And you found a connection to him then. I'm just waking up, so I appreciate these updates.
That's the man himself.
But didn't that letter just say that he was the sword? Is that right?
That is beautiful handwriting.
Or was it on the back? It was in there. Because if he's the sword, he might be badder than you even remember.
The secret of the sword lies with a former Confederate captain who's photographed. I have enclosed with this letter. He's a dangerous sort and may not take kindly to solicitations.
I'd rather die fighting him than live a long life as a coward.
I just want you to know that means he could be the right hand of everything we've been facing up to this point. And it just may not be too bad.
I believe you.
I will help you, but just make the bad.
Yeah.
But I cannot abide him to live. I will not suffer that type of vermin to walk across the earth.
I'm sure we'll find him just fine, Jed. Sounds like they're looking for Gideon, too.
I'll kill that man. You all here are witnesses.
I admire your resolve, Jedediah, and I am happy to be part of your quest.
I'll make sure that they don't get you.
Well, that letter, they're wrong. They say that I'm afraid. I'm not afraid anymore. You guys all got my back, and I got your back. I'm not afraid of these people.
You're quite a talented lad, as I suspected, Gideon.
You give your word that you kill that man, Jeb? I don't want you dying before that.
No. There'll not be a snuff of my life until that man has been strangled beneath my fists. I would not even waste a bullet on the scum that is that man.
Jedediah, do you recall the discussion we had regarding virtues and what I would practice each day? Do you know what I am practicing today?
Nope.
The art of confession. I've not been very good at it, but I figured I'd use my actions to display. And he is doing this with the thing here. I have a very storied history with the bearers of this cross. How many of you caught a glimpse of my eyes when I called to that holy man with the scourge?
I seen it.
I've been touched by the ones who bear these cross. And now I'm using it for righteous purposes. I'm not sure what you saw or what you did to me while I was out, but... well, let's not ruin a good thing, shall we? I believe that is my confession for the time being.
And Jed's gonna shoot another look at Gideon, so you get the gravity of the situation. He spits into his palm and he extends his hand to Levi. If by my life or death I keep you up, you are my trail mate now for life.
He kind of spits and also breathes into it. This might hurt a bit. You feel a slight burning.
The sheriff explodes!
Yep, I feel a slight burning sensation on your hand.
It burns, but that is literally in your hand.
Okay, sweet. You kept it.
That's not the one we found. That one's mine.
This is a wonderful group. A wonderful group indeed.
You have my trust, Mr. Williams.
And you have mine.
What do you think of those
my
that...
My axe!
What do you think of those that burned redstone?
Well...
This ain't them.
Nope. Nor are they fit to live. And there is still a $20 bounty to collect.
Mm-hmm. We still need to find those that burn redstone.
Levi begins using the disguise kit to disguise the scars on his face. There we go. Good as new.
Don't forget the railroad schedule there. It's got a date, place and time circled.
To dig into these clues a little bit more next time.
Yeah, it is getting late, but damn, it's fun.
Mm-hmm.
Well said.
I spent most of Wednesday night making this shit because it's too much fun.
Ballin', man. Well done.
Thank you.
GM gets inspiration. Yeah. Yeah.
Hates you so much.
Yep.
Alright, leads. This gives you a date and time that someone very important is going to be arriving at Promontory Point. I meant to print out a map of Utah, I forgot to. Map of Utah-wise, you were in the northeastern corner of the state. Promontory Point is also in the northeastern corner of the state. This is closest to you. It's also several days away. You have this portrait of this man. Jed feels very strongly about this man. There's some history here.
You actually killed my mother.
You know there is a county nearby, a couple days' ride away, where he's been laying low, trying to hide from the law in the aftermath of the Civil War, and trying to use his men to kill Union people. You know that this illustrates some type of ritual very personal to Gideon. Yeah. And the learned folk...
Yeah, we didn't look at that yet.
Mm.
Yeah?
Oh yeah, there we go. I forgot you were a book man.
A bookist?
We've noticed that perhaps this book was drawn from Salt Lake City Library.
Oh.
No, maybe there's a reward.
And, just because Kay is a bit quiet-voiced. And I've written this myself, so I know what it says. I'll read it one more time so you can stew on it for a week. April 29th, 1880. Dear Francis, I pray this letter finds you well and in good health. I know that the Almighty shines his blessed light upon you, for I have heard good things and good tidings of your efforts in Duchesne County. The swelling of the church swells to my heart in a way that reminds me of you. You may recall, in our many nights together, I have spoken plainly of the moments of solitude, when bare of back, with bloodied cords, that I felt closest to the divine. It was through this connection that we forged our own bond, and it was in one of these moments that I was once again visited by the Archangel Zariah. When Zariah spoke to me, it was with urgent direction. As was Moses tested by the Almighty in Egypt, so too will our faith be challenged by the tasks set upon us. We must bring the four together. Brother Ephraim, in his studies, believes that the secret of the sword lies with a former Confederate captain whose photograph I've enclosed with this letter. He is a dangerous sort and may not take kindly to solicitors. You may wish to open communications with your allies in Texas. Worldly currency may be necessary to bring the captain to heel. I have also been told that the young master has been observed in Hope's Landing. Would that you could spare a faithful soul to return the boy to us. He is young and scared, and lacks the spiritual fortitude to face the realities of the world. My sojourn to Flagstaff nears its end, and I hope to see you again when my train arrives in Promontory next month. Would you believe the good son Demetrius insists on attending me? He's a godly lad. I have agreed to take him with me, along with the anointed knights, on my journey. Fare thee well, my dear Francis. I long only to look upon your face and then feel your touch once more. In Divinity, 1. Shepherd Harlow, Isaac Longwave.
Well, I hope it's not a long wait before the next
episode.